call a Shamrock typically about 20 minutes out. If it's by air, usually 30 minutes to get everybody ready. Shamrocks are based on the number of patients that are coming in. We've chosen red, white, blue, and black. Red means there's one patient, black means there's four or more.
Kind of code for the hospital telling us how many patients are inbound and that we need to report in as soon as possible. And so anytime a trauma is brought in, we kind of need everyone to come on in and help make sure that the patient's taken care of.
Exploded.
You know, it gets pretty hectic in there, especially during traumas. We're looking at our patients and evaluating to see who is the worst off, who needs to go into the OR, who needs to go to CT, who needs blood, who we need to intubate.
It's one continuous evaluation. All that goes on fairly rapidly, probably within the first 3 to 4 minutes. Hey, ma'am, is there one more coming? He's got a little bit of singeing on the right hand, but second degree burn here on the wrist.
Trauma tends to be a chaotic experience. Patients are brought in with no clear, definite diagnoses.
It looks like chaos, but everybody that's here has a specific job that they know how to do very well.
X-ray. Shoot an X-ray.
Each of us bring our own specialty expertise to the table. We've broken things down into a system where we each have our responsibilities.
We actually have a sequence that we kind of go through. So as you're watching, you may not be able to sort of perceive that, but there actually is a relative checklist to make sure that nothing gets missed for evaluation and treatment of the patient.
It's a nurse anesthetist that's responsible for managing the airway. And we focus on the things that are going to kill the patient in a very rapid manner. Okay, the things we're concerned about is airway. Do they have an open airway and can they breathe? That's the two first questions we ask. If they don't have an open airway, we open it for them. And that might be putting an ET tube down their throat, or it might be doing a cricothyroidotomy in their neck. We have two technicians, one on either side, responsible for starting the IVs.
The lab turnaround, I've never seen a civilian facility that has a lab turnaround that we have. So essentially, we're not even done completely assessing the patient and we have our lab results back.
Yeah, it looks like an AK-47 kind of...
All of those bone fragments yeah. Secondary projectiles in there.
Our CAT scanner is literally about 40 feet that way down the hall. Our ability to respond quickly to whatever the patient might need is really excellent. The operating room literally is just through those doors.
A 22-year-old Afghan female. She showed up to the gate one day, unannounced. We just went out and picked her up. And she walked in and she was in a burqa. And you can see when she had the burqa on that her left arm was badly burned and it was black. As soon as we sat her in this table, we took her burqa off and her whole face was burned. her left breast, her left shoulder. And she'd been sitting at home for 40 hours, ignored.
To be honest, none of us thought she was gonna make it. She was so badly burnt. We had her in the OR every single day, fixing her wounds, skin grafting her, everything. You know, we took pictures from every day. She drastically changed when she first got to us. She was very swollen. We couldn't see any of her characteristics really because she was so badly charred. She didn't even really look like a human being. She was so charred. And then little by little, she started getting her characteristics back. My brother brought fuel into the house for a generator, but the cap was not very secure. My young daughter was playing in the living room and knocked the fuel can over, spilling the gas all over the floor. When I came in to clean it, I got gas on my clothes. I then went to make tea in the kitchen for my mother, and my dress caught on fire.
Has some limited range of motion in her left hand. She'll need a little bit more work on her face. She's gonna be able to live a decent life. Had we left her downtown, she would have died. I mean, I think they probably intended just to leave her where she was and let her die. I mean, women in this country are viewed as objects. They get very little respect. I think we treated her with respect the whole time she was here. And as her care went on, her personality started to come out. Very nice woman. By the time she left here, she was smiling. Very thankful, very grateful for everything that we've done for her.
I am so happy with how the doctors took care of me, and I'm so thankful for them. I think of all of them as my brothers and sisters. She's amazing. I don't know what else to say except for I wish I had the same kind of courage that she does to continue on in this kind of situation.
I mean, from my own personal standpoint, my heroes are not movie stars or athletes. It's the Rangers and young Army men. And they're willing to risk their lives for the freedom of my children. And I'm a little too old to go out and do it myself. But I can be a surgeon and make sure that they understand that the people that take care of them care an awful lot about. Same blood around the D-Force. Looks good. Oh. Wrong.
We're going to put a C-collar on you just so that we can try to make sure that your head stays stable and all that good stuff, all right?
Yeah.
Once you get an IV in, we're going to give you some pain medicine.
There it is.
Of this courageous soldier recover to full health. Watch over him. Give him strength. You're going to be all right, okay?
We got three Americans in, and during that day, we weren't able to save one of them, and we tried for hours, and that was pretty hard. I cried a lot for a while, and I'll always remember that soldier's name.
When you're done at the end of the day, and you go back to your hooch, let's just say you just lost an American, which has happened, all that comes rushing back to you. And it is very difficult. I have had some very emotional days here. My first was soon after I had gotten here, probably just a few weeks after I'd gotten here, we had lost an American soldier. And that's probably the toughest time I've ever had as a surgical technician. You want to be able to save everybody. It's just, it's not something that you can allow yourself to think about at the moment, because you know that you have a job to do. Thank you.